Kate Dwyer of Ireland now, Snud and Fabergé. This horse a real character. It's known as Fabio in the stable. Kate's based in Dunboyne over in Ireland. Finished just outside the top 10 in the Grand Prix and the Freestyle at Kiso back in March. It's the horse's fifth international Grand Prix here last night. This is going to be interesting, actually, because last night she had to really encourage the horse to be a bit more active within the movements. And I think tonight the music can sometimes just help a little bit with that.
Absolutely. It gives them a little bit more energy and it really does help the rider. So I think hopefully tonight she's going to have that easier ride. Different music, isn't it?
Yeah, if I was picking music for this horse, I would go with big, powerful beats.
Not this. I think it's going to be from the Pocahontas.
Yeah, it might be.
She's been very clever with the music, actually. Using this music, it makes him look lighter on his feet.
Uh-huh.
So it makes the passage look a lot lighter, especially coming into the PF there.
Have you ever been tempted to use some Disney music?
Look at me, I love Disney. I am Disney.
See, that music just, it was growing. Just quiets down a little bit as she comes into the PF.
You can just see there that she's encouraging him just to keep the PF in time with the music. Mm. And then hit that transition out into the passage there. There's that powerful music for you there, for that extended trot. See, she was waiting. It was in there.
She's been listening. Nice even rhythm in the walk.
You did pick something up from yesterday evening.
Yeah, see?
Nice to see she's keeping the same theme with through the whole program with the music.
Two time changes.
Using that 10 metre loop again that we saw earlier.
It's quite creative, I like that.
Do you?
I do. Do you do that in your freestyle floor plan?
I'm going to now.
You should. And then into the one time.
music changing there, just cueing in the canter pirouette again. It's nice to see that you've got that little bit of noise there every time the right forearm came up.
Yeah. And back to those two times. See if she's going to pop in the one-time changes again, coming back.
I think it's always very brave when the rider adds another lot of changes in there if they hadn't had a mistake previously.
Yeah, you've already ticked that box. You've already
Absolutely.
Got in what you had to do. A few things to like in this test so far.
Absolutely, going into you were right, she's gone into those one times there. Done them on the diagonal line this time just to make it a little bit different.
So that shows that she's very confident in those changes.
Yes, it does, and you know, good.
Yes. Dwyer there with Snowden Fabergé representing Ireland here.
I think the music was really well suited. I know you want to see something a little bit more powerful, but yep. He is a big horse, so it's great to see that he used the music there to make him look a little bit lighter on his toes. Just how you dance on a Saturday night, right?
Exactly, very light on my toes. She had some nice changes as well, didn't she?
She did, and that's really good. It's really nice to see that the rider is confident enough in the changes like that to add them in twice, you know, because that is, once again, difficult, so it really helps with that higher mark there.
Now, when you're choosing your music, do you always try and keep the same theme, like what she did?
Yes, you do. You know, you want the music to work. You want it to be easy to work, to watch. You don't want it to be really noisy and not working. So it is sort of the same theme is really what you want to do and hit on. But it is really difficult to put a floor bland together. It takes quite a lot of time to do. So usually what most riders do is that at home, they put the floor plan together, then they send that video away to somebody who then adds the music to, and then they talk back and forth to find out exactly how they want to make it work. And then you get it home again, and then suddenly have to remember what you actually did in the first place to fit the music.
Okay. So it's a long process, a lot of work involved.
It does take a lot of time as well, because there's bits of music that you'd like to use as a rider that actually you think, oh, that doesn't work now.
Yeah.
So there's always a lot of changing and cutting and stuff like that. But once you get your final program, and you want to...